Hello students, welcome to the video lecture series of class 12th business studies. Today we are going to start a new chapter, chapter number 6 of your first book, that is staffing. You are already aware of the 5 functions of management, that is planning, organizing, staffing, directing and controlling. So you have noticed that staffing function follows planning and organizing. Under planning, it is decided what is to be done and how it is to be done. Under organizing, organization structure is designed, departments and job positions are created, and at staffing function, all the job positions which are created at organizing stage, they are filled with people. So let's see what staffing function is all about. Let us first start with the meaning of staffing. Staffing is that part of process of management which is concerned with obtaining, utilizing and maintaining satisfactory and a satisfied workforce. Let us see one more definition of staffing. Staffing is described as managerial function of filling and keeping the filled positions in the organization structure. The important point which is stressed in both the definitions which we have discussed right now is, we have to find a right person for a right job. Also, we have to ensure that employees are satisfied and they do not leave our organization. Now let us see the process of staffing. The stages in the process of staffing are, first, estimating manpower requirement, second, recruitment, third, selection, fourth, placement and orientation, fifth, training and development, sixth, performance appraisal, seventh, promotion and career planning, eighth, compensation. Now let us discuss these steps in detail. So the first step is estimating manpower requirement. For estimating the manpower requirement, we have to find out how many persons we need in the organization and of what type. For example, I have to clearly specify that I need 4 drivers, I need 7 salesmen, I need 1 finance manager. So you have to tell them how many people do you need and of what qualification and what type. It requires 2 type of analysis, workload analysis and workforce analysis. Workload analysis means assessment of number and the type of human resource necessary for the performance of various jobs in the organization. So it is basically linked with the requirement which is there in the organization. And second type of analysis is workload analysis. This type of analysis reveals the number and the type of human resource which are already available in the organization. So basically it is linked with availability of what type of people are already available in the organization. So this exercise of doing workload analysis will reveal whether our organization is understaffed, overstaffed, or it is optimally staffed. Now let us understand what understaffing and overstaffing is. You can see the first figure. In the first figure you can see the number of people required in the organization are 10. But actual number is 6. This is called as understaffing. Now you can see the second figure which is there. Here you can see that the number of people required in the organization is 6. But the actual number of people who are there in organization, this is 12. So this particular situation is called as overstaffing. And to tell you, both these situations, understaffing and overstaffing, they are not required, they are undesirable. The organization should aim to be optimally staffed. And what do you mean by optimally staffed is, there should be neither shortage nor surplus manpower in the organization. And in case organization is facing a problem of understaffing, what business need to do is, they need to appoint more people. And in case business is facing the situation of overstaffing, business should remove the excess employees or transfer them to some other branch or some other department where there is shortage. Now we'll come to the second step. The second step of staffing process is recruitment. Recruitment may be defined as process of searching for prospective employees, stimulating them to apply for the jobs in the organization. And the main objective why recruitment is done, so that we have pool of prospective job candidates from which we can select the best candidate for our organization. And to tell you, higher the number of people who apply for the job, higher will be the possibility that organization will get a suitable candidate. Because in this case, there will be a wider choice with the management from which they can select the best candidate. Higher the number of people who apply for the job, higher will be the possibility of getting suitable candidates for the organization. For recruitment, business can use two sources, internal sources as well as external sources. Internal sources is when the applicant for job are from within the organization, and external sources is when the applicant from job, they are applying from outside the business. So these are the two types of sources, internal sources as well as external sources. Now we will come to the third step, that is selection. Selection is a process of identifying and choosing the best person out of the prospective candidates for the job. Selection process is beneficial both to the organization as well as to the selected employee. With selection, organization gets the best among the available candidates, and the benefit which is there for the employee is it enhances the self-esteem and the prestige of selected employee. Selection process involves different steps or stages. And at every stage, few people are eliminated and there are few who move to the next stage. And this continues till the right candidate is found. Step number four is placement and orientation. This step is related to employee joining the job in the organization. Placement refers to employee occupying the position or the post for which he or she has been selected. Whereas orientation is introducing the selected employee to the other employees, familiarizing him with the rules, policies of the organization. Students, this step is very important because employees' experiences during orientation and placement form his or her first impression about the organization. Organization has to be very careful that they design a good orientation program for the employee. Step number five is training and development. Employees need to know the new skills, and it is beneficial for both employees' career growth as well as growth of the organization. By offering the opportunities for career advancement to their members, organization not only attract but also retain the talented people in the organization. So now we'll come to the definition of training. Training is a process by which attitude, skill, abilities of a particular employee to perform a particular job, they are enhanced or increased. Whereas development is a broader concept. It refers to learning opportunities designed to help employees grow and get higher jobs in future. So it is related to development of maturity level of employee, personality of an employee. So it is more career oriented. Step number six is performance appraisal. Performance appraisal basically means evaluating an employee's current or a past performance against certain predetermined standards. So it is similar to the report card. In the report card, you get your grades for different exams. Similarly, the employee's performance appraisal report, all the performance of employee is written, whether it is a past performance or a current performance, everything is recorded in the performance appraisal report. In this case, it is very important to know that employee should be aware of the standards or the targets which are set for him or her. And it is a duty of a superior to give a regular feedback to employee about his performance, that whether he has improved the performance or the performance has decreased. All this feedback should be regularly provided to the employees. Step number seven is promotion and career planning. manager need to design the activities to serve the employee's long-term interest also. Every employee joined the organization with certain dreams. He want to grow in the organization. He want to take up higher post in the organization. So organization has to keep this thing in mind. They must encourage the employee to grow and realize their full potential. Promotion is an integral part of person's career. Promotion will lead to more pay, more status, and more responsibilities for the employee. Now we'll come to the last step, that is step 8, compensation. Organization need to design the wage and the salary plan for the employees. So compensation basically refers to all form of pay or the rewards which are going to the employees. It may be in the form of direct financial incentives, for example, wages, salaries, incentives, commission, bonuses, and indirect payments like paid insurance, paid vacations, medical insurance. So all this come under the category of indirect payments. So we have seen that staffing is not merely putting a right person on a right job, but it also includes various other activities like training, performance appraisal, compensation. So it is not a narrow concept, it is a broader concept. I want to share with you what Mr. Narayan Murthy, CEO of Infosys, has said about manpower. Our assets walk out of our door each evening. We have to make sure that they come back next morning. This statement clearly states that the foundation of any organization is talented and the hardworking people, and they are the principal assets of the firm. You may have other assets, you may have a land, building, machinery, but out of all your assets, which is the most important asset of your business is human resource. The right people can help you take your business to the top, whereas the wrong people can break your business. Hence, staffing is a fundamental and the critical drive of the organizational performance. So let us discuss the importance of staffing function. Importance of staffing can be explained with the help of following points. First, discovering and obtaining competent personnel for a job. Second, higher performance. Third, continuous survival and growth of an enterprise. Fourth, optimum utilization of human resource. And fifth, improves job satisfaction and morale of employees. So let's discuss these points in detail. So let's start with the first point, discovering and obtaining competent personnel for a job. It is because of staffing function, organization is able to get right and a competent personnel for a job. And this happens due to following of a right recruitment and a selection process by which the best candidate is selected. Second, higher performance. Performance of employee increases if job offered to them is suitable to them. And staffing function ensures that the right person is put on a right job. Third, continuous survival and growth of an enterprise. Staffing helps in identifying and developing internal people with the potential to fill the key business leadership positions in the company in future. This is called as succession planning, which helps in survival and the growth of an enterprise. Fourth point, optimum utilization of human resources. Students, we have already done what overstaffing is and what understaffing is. In both the cases, we are not utilizing our human resources properly. So staffing ensures that organization is neither understaffed nor overstaffed, rather it is optimally staffed, and all the resources, including human resource, they are optimally utilized in the organization. Fifth point is improved job satisfaction and morale of employees. The process of staffing provide right kind of work environment and the culture where there's an objective assessment of employees' performance and employees are fairly rewarded for their contribution. And this increases the satisfaction and the morale of employees. Therefore, we can say that staffing is very important managerial function. No organization can be successful unless it can fill and keep the filled positions provided in the structure with the right kind of people. Students, in our next lecture, we will discuss in detail the recruitment step of staffing, what are the various sources of recruitment, and the comparison of different sources of recruitment.